Right, so, Real Madrid away. This was never going to be easy. Not just because we'd managed to lose 3-1 at home in the first leg, but due to this channel not exactly being the cash cow I wanted it to be, the only financially viable way into Madrid was by flying to Porto, then getting a 6-hour overnight coach to Madrid and not booking any accommodation. Honestly, it seemed like a good idea at the time. Oh yeah, also, Chelsea, being the bastards that they are, wrote everyone's name and passport number on the match tickets. So me, being someone who lives off spares, there was a very good chance I'd go through all this just to be turned away at the door, but fuck it. You cannot say no to the Bernabeu, can you? Get to Liverpool Street and board the Stansted Express at around 11 p.m, knowing full well I'd probably just had my last night's sleep for 2 days. Arrive at Stansted. My mates are running further behind than an illegal football stream, so go through security on my own and kill time by playing some weird Cadbury's football game in duty free. Pals do arrive and we hit the Wetherspoons for a quick one. Not quick enough though, as we have to rush off as our flight is boarding and our gate is further away than we thought. I'm in the front row of the plane, meaning I've actually got leg room for once, which is an absolute blessing. Realistically, my arse is never touching a first class seat, so this was like a nice little taste of the high life that I'll never get to live. Touchdown in Porto and we've got time to kill before the coach. I'm aware that you're watching this video because I put Thogden's name in the title and not to see me have a casual evening in Porto, but in case of some of you thinking about going there, I'll sum it out quickly now. The houses look like your nan's wallpaper. They build bridges out of pylons, they eat flaming penis and bread for dinner, they only drink half pints, and their men's and ladies' bathroom signs have an outrageous amount of drip. Oh yeah, and watch out for the pedos. Other than that though, beautiful city, would recommend. Get to the coach station. After a day of Superbox sangrias, finding out the toilet didn't fucking work was an absolute nightmare. We distracted ourselves by watching Kai Havertz compilations and Peep Show, but sleeping was out of the question at this point. After 6 hours and a stop at a service station that was selling very suspect mugs, we had eventually arrived in Madrid. Once our sleep-deprived selves had worked out to use the Spanish metro system, we headed into the city centre. At this point, I was beyond tired, so we checked into the cheapest hostel we could find and crashed for a couple hours before picking ourselves back up again to start drinking. We're in Plaza Mayor all day, enjoying beers, sangria, tapas, paella, and a Manchester City flag so basic it was actually very confusing. Manchester City, Premier League. What's that supposed to mean? It's at this point we are joined by the legend that is Thogden. I just want to take some time out to thank him for giving this shitty little channel a shout out on his vlog, because he really did not need to do that and it's already boosted my numbers massively. So Theo, if you're watching this, thanks for that and continue to do what you're doing on your channel, it's class. Oh, and if you're ever at a Chelsea game again and don't mind me shamelessly shoving you into the title and thumbnail, please do let me know. Eventually the time came to head to the ground. There were people checking tickets and names and that on the outside, but I still managed to get through, which was a huge buzz. Realising I was about to watch my team play at the biggest club in the world had always been a dream of mine, so to realise it was just so special. The game kicks off and we are fantastic, straight into Madrid and taking the game to them. After 15 minutes, Mason Mount curls one past Big Nose in the goal and suddenly there's belief in the away end. We could actually fucking do this. The first half, we were fantastic and the away end is as loud as any I've ever experienced. As it got to half time, there was a real sense of pride and hope among our fans. We were winning at the fucking Bernabeu. One more and we had levelled the tie. We come out flying in the second half, playing as well as I've seen us. We win a corner which is crossed into Rudiger. Fucking carnage. We actually done it. 2-0, 3-3 on aggregate. Genuinely unbelievable. The away end is bouncing at this point. We can go through. We're going to do this. Chelsea continue to dominate the game and have attack after attack. Eventually, the ball bounces for Alonso. Oh my god. The end falls sideways. We're 3-0 up. Come on. This is the greatest moment of my... Oh, just fuck off VAR, you bastards. We thought that was it. We tried, but they had robbed us. Nothing more we could do. But the team kept going. Then Werner was played through. He sat two defenders down. Shot, deflected. There it was. The best moment I've ever experienced in a ground. It was less a celebration, more an out-of-body experience. We all know what went on to happen in this game, but that moment there, that will stay with me forever. With 10 minutes to go, naturally, it all goes wrong. Kante loses the ball, Luka Modric plays an utterly outrageous pass over the top to Rodrigo, who scores to level on aggregate, and the tie eventually goes to extra time. As we stood there waiting for extra time to begin, no one could believe that we'd made it this far. Nothing mattered from this point on. We'd gone to the Bernabeu and played him off the park. We'd not laid down and put up an enormous fight. Around 5 minutes into extra time, Benzema scores and we're all but out. We have chances from then till full time, but ultimately we knew how it was ending. The whistle blows to seal our fate and the fans applaud the players off. Sure, it was painful, but we've really done ourselves proud and shown that we are a club that not only belongs in this competition, but is integral to it as a spectacle. After being kept behind for an hour, we were directed out the ground by the Spanish Op Bill, and that was that. Chelsea's first visit to the Bernabeu was over, but it will never be forgotten. Football is weird, isn't it? Watching my team win away at Real Madrid had been on my bucket list my entire life, and it turned out to be the most tiring and painful experience ever. Went between three countries in 3 days with 4 hours sleep just to get knocked out. I really, really need to get a life. Just a game at the end of the day though, innit? We're gonna play football, soccer, football, soccer, football, soccer, all around the world.